Says like this, yo-yo. In Perek Aleph Mishnah Dalet, it says as follows. Let's get yo-yo, you have down the
I'm excited, Ezra, when we get back, yo-yo, when we get back to Durham and I'm going to be saying like a shvach avert, I could see Viggy and a lot of guys going like it's a new way of telling a Rebbe, like you're not saying so sharp. You can have like 20 guys going. It's a new, like, respectful way of telling, of telling the speaker, you've heard it's a shtickle choppy for all different reasons. We've developed a lot of interesting habits, but okay. I please ask if it's ever choppy, go like this, or a bad word also. If you don't like something that says, feel free. The only thing I say is if the sound is choppy, then I could do, Yaakov could do something about it. If the word is like this, I don't know if Yaakov could fix up the shtickle teir. Then maybe I'll just put Yaakov on or something to fix it up. Like this, Rabbi say, the Mishnah says it's talking about a person learning from a Talmud Chacham, and it says v'havei misaveik ba'afar ragleim. And part of a shaychus to a Talmud Chacham, part of learning from a Talmud Chacham is hachna. Is humility is to humble oneself to a Talmud Chacham. Because there's a big chevra, both the Imre chevra, Shloima Gorin, and the Imre chevra, and Akiva Nathan and the Taras Chaim chevra are learning Baba Kama. Very bekitzer, we'll just say the Gemara and Baba Kama, Meir Friedler, very briefly. The Gemara and Baba Kama. Very good, Yaakov. The Gemara and Baba Kama on Chafam days. Where Rami Bar Chama says to Reb Chista, Rami Bar Chama says to Reb Chista that if you want an answer to your shaila, Reb Chista had asked the shaila, a question, and Yo-Yo Rami Bar Chama says to Reb Chista, if you want an answer to your shaila, Karach li sudri, lechita shamishli, serve me and I'll give an answer to your shaila. Rami Bar Chama told Reb Chista, serve me and I'll answer you. Now, I didn't speak to Yaakov about this part, but Reb Chista was a Kohen, and it's Paskind and Shulchan Aruch. Reb Chista was a Kohen, Zevi Katz, Reb Chista was a Kohen. Are you allowed to ask Zevi Katz to do you a service? No, siree. The Halacha and Siman Kuf Chav Ches of Shulchan Aruch. Srili Reuben, the Halacha and Siman Kuf Chav Ches. On my screen, Srili, you're sitting next to your brother Tzvi. It's so beautiful. The two brothers are sitting next to each other. I love it. I love it. They're sitting mamish next to each other. I like it. So Tzvi and Srili, two precious brothers. In Siman Kuf Chav Ches Bin Stein, it says in Shulchan Aruch, Sifkat Mem Hei, Aser L'shtamesh B'Kayin. You're not allowed to use a kohen as your board. You're not allowed to ask a kohen, I love you, Ezra. You can't ask a kohen to work for you. Afilu bizman hazeh, even today's day and age, im loy machal al kach, if the kohen's not meichel. You need to ask mechila from the kohen. If the kohen's not meichel, you're not allowed to ask him to serve you. Now, I always wondered what the case is, Evi Gerala. Because if he does it, he obviously was Meichel. So Be'emes, I'm bothered by Revezi. It says you're not allowed to make a Kohen work for you unless he's Meichel. I mean, what's the case? If he did it, he's obviously Meichel. But that's halacha, it's a Ramah. It's aser l'shtamish b'kohen afil b'zman hazeh. Put on Revezi, I need a pshat. Revezi, what's pshat?
Read the Gemara in the Gemara. Clear, Reb Chiya here, Reb Chista is doing it just to get a different service. It wasn't voluntary.
So Rav Ezi says, what's the scenario? I'm asking Rabbi say, what does that mean? You can't make a kohen work unless he's Meichel. If he does it, he's obviously Meichel. So Rav Ezi says, lav dafka. Over here, Reb Chista only wants to get pshat. So you tell him, do it, and he only wants to get pshat. It's also to be mishtamish with the kohen. There could be cases, you have to be very careful. If you ask a kohen to do something and he only does it because of pressure, he's not moichel. L'maisa had it, Rami Bar Chama asked Reb Chista to do it. So the Magen Avraham, we're a little choppy.
I know that's Ezi's vert. You're going like this on one. He went thumbs up, so I'm not sure. But the kids, the kids are Advarim is, I say, that the Magen Avraham asked, had it Rami Bar Chama and our Gemara asked Reb Chista, do something, serve me, and I'll tell you pshat. You're not allowed to have a kohen serve you. Says the Magen Avraham in Halacha, says the Magen Avraham, that this is the Ramaz Raya, the kohen could be Michael. Reb Chista was Michael. Reb Chista was Michael. He speaks that out. Rami Bar Chai Mishamish Reb Chista, Sheyu kohen, because he was Michael. That's what the Magen Avraham says. Is the Ramaz Raya that if you're Michael, you're allowed to do it. If Zevi Katz is Michael, then he's allowed to serve you. If he's not Michael, he can't serve you. Now, the Kasha I asked before, I'm not sure the Pshat, that isn't he always Michael? Maybe Rav Ezi's right. We'll leave that as a Kasha. But the Bema is like this. Rami Bar Chama asked Rav Chista to serve him. The Gemara wants you to know that it's a chiddush. You're not supposed to ask a kohen, but he gets his mechila. So ask Reb Shimon Shkaf, why do he want him to serve him? And the Gemara says that shakol sudre karachle. Reb Chista takes Rami Bar Chama's scarf and he folds it. Rabbi say, Benny Stein, years ago, somebody told me about a certain sefer. Zevi, a guy told me about a certain sefer. So I went as a meragel. As a spy, I took the sefer, and I figured, let me like spy a little. Mayor Friedel, I opened up the sefer, the book, and I looked a little, and I said, nothing here, and I put it away. I didn't see anything, Yishmak. You spy through the sefer. It's happened to me a number of times. I'm remembering a specific time. Then came later on, Zevi Sher, I really learned the sefer. There was a reason that I wanted to study the Sefer. And when I learned the Sefer and I had a reason to learn it, I was amazed by what it said in the Sefer. What happened? When I spied out on the Sefer, I didn't really find anything geschmack there. And when I sat and I learned it, I was very impressed what I saw in the Sefer. Good line, Shlomo Gorn. And I'll tell you the pshat. The pshat is Meish Glazer, I love you and I'm thankful that you're here. It means a lot. And I'll tell you pshat, Chevra. The pshat was that you have to learn by a Talmud Chacham with hachno, with humility. The Mishnah says, have a misavek ba'afar ragleim. If you want to get from a Talmud Chacham, you have to come with humility. When I went to look at the Sefer and I was spying what it says, I went with gaiva. I wasn't saying this is a Talmud Chacham I want to learn by. So I wasn't properly medayik in his words. But when I came as a student, then I saw what he was saying and I was amazed. Reb Shimon Shkop writes as an introduction that my Sefer has very deep things. But if you come just as a tourist, you're just going to say, I don't know what he's saying, and you're going to put it away. It's only if you come with the humility will you understand what I'm saying. Says Rav Shimon Shkop, that's why Rami Bar Chama wanted Rav Chista to serve him. He said, only I'm going to tell you an answer that's complicated. But if you come with Hachna, you understand that I'm a Rebbe and you do a pu'ula to serve me, you come with that Hachna, with that humility, you'll put time into what I'm saying. You'll put effort. You'll see I'm telling you a good verse. That's what the Mishnah is saying, Rabbi Misavik Ba'afar Ragleim. The approach to a Talmud Chacham has to be an action of Achna. My father, my Rebbe, used to tell us, if you told my father, only a close student or a child of my father, if we would say, Abba, how does Abba learn Pshat in this Gemara? Ooh, would we get a yelling? You don't ask a Rebbe, how does Rebbe learn Pshat in this Gemara? You say, what is Pshat? How does Rebbe learn Pshat? Means you tell me your idea. Let me, you know, I'm going to, you don't ask a Rebbe, could you tell me Rebbe's Pshat? What is Pshat? And it wasn't some acute thing. This is the Yisai that I learned from a Rebbe with Hachna, with a certain humility. That is Mis'avek Ba'far Ragleim. Beis Chabeis Vad L'Chachamim says to have Shaychus to a Talmud Chacham. Mis'avek, but a Shaychus, remember that Mishnah said he should come to your house. He comes to your house, as you're the Baal Abbas, and he's a guest by you. You're the Baalim. Having Mis'avek Ba'far Ragleim is another level of connection to the Rebbe, that you have a achna, you have a humility, that is v'habe misadik ba'afar ragleim. That is the achna that's necessary in the relationship. Let us move on to Mishnah Hay. I would like to study very, very badly Mishnah Hay with the Chevra. Perfect. Let's get Mishnah Hay as follows. Yaisi ben Yoichanan Ishu Shalayim Omer. Yaisi ben Yochanan Ishu Shalayim says as follows, Yebeischa pasuach lirivacha. Your house should be wide open. The word lirivacha is a difficult word. It means very spaciously. The Mishnah should say, Yebeischa pasuach, your house should be open. What does it mean, lirivacha? So Reb Chaim Volozhin explains that often people are afraid to give. They feel times are tight. My finances are tight. My time is limited. I'm going to lose. Says Reb Chaim Volozhin, Yebeischa pasuach, your house should be open, lirivacha. Lirivacha, he says, Reb Chaim Volozhin means for your own benefit. Ravchus means your own gains. Yebeischa pasuach, open up your house, lirivacha, for your own benefits, you will gain from it. Give and you will get. And he says there's a tremendous segula of giving chesed, that a person does chesed will gain from it. So yebeischa pasuach lirvacha means simply pashat pshat. The lirvacha is a gishmak pshat of Reb Chaim Volozhin. But I want to learn with you simple today, and I want to share a yisaid that I will pound this yisaid home. We've been learning for a couple of years this yisaid. I won't stop teaching Gav if you keep listening. If you stop listening, then I'll say it to myself. I have a Pashut Yisoid that I must learn with everybody, and you're going to have a new understanding of a Gemara Brachas. I never even told Yosef Mam in this Pshat. Listen, Yosef, to this Pshat. Yebeischa pasuach lirvacha. Firstly, physically give to people. That's your house open. Give from your house to people. We just had in the parasha the sugya of nigei batim, which is a person who didn't share his house, who doesn't share his possessions. Yebeischa pasuach lirvacha, open up your house, share your things with others. That is the first step of this Mishnah. An open house means to share your things with others, the physical giving of your gifts to others. That's the first step of the Mishnah. The next one is v'yiyu aniyim b'nei beisecha. Yiyu aniyim b'nei beisecha means it's not enough to give the ani. It already said yebeischa pasuach. Your house is open, which means you're giving to the ani. Yiyu aniyim b'nei beisecha, says Reb Chaim Volozhin, means that it's not enough to give to the poor man. He should be a member of your household. Give him love. Give him love. Give him encouragement, just like your children. You give them affection. You give them time. You give them encouragement. Yiyu aniyim b'nei beisecha means don't just physically give the aniyim. Give them chizuk. That's yiyu aniyim b'nei beisecha. Watch this, my chevra. The Gemara in Brachas quotes a pasuk in Isaiah. Everybody knows. The pasuk says, Zaru lachem l'tzedaka. It considers charity, giving physical money or items to an ani, that is considered tzedakah, that's a zriya, planting. B'katzru l'fi chesed, but the harvesting is according to the chesed. Tzedakah is the physical gifts. chesed is the chizuk. It says if you give tzedakah to an ani, you get 6 blessings. But amifaisoi b'dvarim, if you encourage him, you get yud aleph, you get 11 blessings. Always giving things to somebody is considered planting, but you harvest according to the chizuk. What this means, Menachem Wiener, listen to what it means, but I'm going to tell you, Yosef Mam, in a nupshat. Yo-Yo, I want you to hear this. Yo-Yo, an ani comes to your table, you're at a chasna. We're going to be at Ezra Shulman's chasna, Beis Hashem, B'roi Vam, minimum 1,000 people. There's going to be rules with chasnas, but this summer's chasnas, we need B'roi Vam. I have a shtickle answer, even though Ezra, they say, our tzaddikim said 250, but your chasna, we're going to dance with Srili Rubin and Srili Snyder. So I have at the 250 per chasna. So Srili Rubin comes, gives us 250 more guys. Srili Snyder's another 250. Elazar Nemat, that's 1,000. There may be a few more chasan. Right now we're at 1,000. That was my cheshbon. Now, in the guidelines, 1,000. Okay, we'll see. And they said 250, the Gedolim was stark about this. So right now you have to have 1,000, as it will work if there's a few more. Okay. Ketzer Advarim. Yo-Yo, we're going to be at the table. Be'ez Hashem. Ezra Suda, we're going to be sitting at the table, Yo-Yo. And an ani comes collecting. So you hand him $1. That is planting. You didn't harvest. You only plant in order to harvest. You planted when you give him $1, but the real zchus, the real merit, the real question of this deed, is it going to have payrus, is did you give the ani encouragement? If you smile at him, if you give him chizuk, amifaisoi b'dvarim, then you harvested. The action was the $1, the chizuk, and encouragement, then you've harvested. That's what this Mishnah is saying. The Mishnah says, Yabez Chapasuach, first of all, your house should be open. Share with the ani. Give him physical things. But that's not enough. Yiyu aniyim b'nei ve'secha, they should be members of your home, receiving love and warmth, affection, validation. They're members of your home. Now, simple pshat, Zevi Gerala, what am I giving these two things? Maishi Kalish, why am I giving these two things? Simple pshat is people have physical needs and emotional needs. So the simple pshat is that besides caring for his physical need, care for his emotional needs. More important than milk is a smile. People's emotional needs are more important than physical. So that's the simple pshat, Manny, but it's not the full story, not nearly. Because if that was so, who said the ani needs your emotional support? Who said? It says, maybe he doesn't need my emotional support. Why is the Mishnah saying, why does the Gemara say that it's much more important, and it considers it the tzira of the Maisa Chesed. More, what I want to really say deeper, why it can't be pshat, is because then if that was pshat, that there's two dinim, there's his physical needs and emotional, one wouldn't be called a zriya and one a ktsira. They're two different things. He has two tzrachim. They're both ktsirais. From the fact that it called one a planting and one a harvesting shows me that it changes the nature. The planting was only successful if you harvested. If you didn't harvest, so you wasted your time planting. If he had two needs, I didn't waste my time. I met one need, missed the other. Rabbi said, the pshat is like this. The pshat is like this. And I'll say this, I want every guy to hear this for a minute. If every guy can hear Rabbi say, there are two kinds of kindness. One hurts people and one saves life. One, you're a Ben Avram, and one is not a Ben Avram. There's a kindness that's born out of pity. Yana nebuch, to be good to him, that's not a good kindness. That doesn't do good to people. You can give a guy $1,000. You didn't do good for him. The Gemara in Kedushin, speaking about Kibbutz Av'eim, says, Yesh machal aviv pisyuni. You can feed your father fancy birds, a great dish that you worked very hard to make for hours. You slave to make your father a dish, and you won't get schar for it because you gave him disrespect when you fed him. The Pshat Rabbi say chesed can't come from a place of pity. The chesed that Avraham Avinu taught us is I love you, admire you, and it's my honor to serve you. When you give the money to the ani, that is an act of planting. The harvesting is what do you say to him? What is your attitude to him? If your attitude is one of validation and love and appreciation, then your ma'isa chesed you have harvested. Then your ma'isa chesed bears tremendous payrise. Then it has tremendous gains, the ma'isa chesed. So we must make sure, yebeis ha-pasuach, let your house be wide open. Give physically to the ani. But yiyu aniyim b'nei beisecha, treat them with love. Treat those that need with respect and validation. That b'nei bayis, your b'nei bayis, the ava, the value, the haracha that you give to your b'nei bayis, give to those that need. With tremendous respect, with tremendous kavod, that is what the Mishnah is telling us. So this Mishnah describes an idealist who's giving to others, and the giving is coming from a place of love and respect and appreciation. That's what this Mishnah describes. Now the Mishnah says, my friends, Al tar besicha ma'isha, don't speak a lot to a woman. And we have studied this subject matter before. I want to read the whole Mishnah, but I want everybody to hear this. This Mishnah is describing a great idealist who's giving to others and giving kavod to others, born from respect, born from love and validation. This Mishnah is describing the epitome of a person who's a giver and giving from a place of great kavod, encouraging others. That's what this Mishnah is describing. Now the Mishnah says, Al tar besicha me'isha, don't speak a lot to a lady. Be'ishtai amru, on your own wife, we have to be careful not to speak at certain times when she's usher. Kal b'chayme be'ishas chaveiroi, not to speak too with our own wives, to be careful how we speak at the times when they're halachos that we have to be zahir from. Kal b'chayme be'ishas chaveiroi, to be careful. Mikanamu chachamim, kozman shadamar b'sich me'isha, mei goyrim rolatz, mei baitel medibri toiv, v'soif yerushkan. What shaykhis, Rabbi say? We have studied this subject matter many times, Shimi. When a person does a mitzvah and a person's on fire with idealism, they are at threat to do averus. We've seen this all our lives. The most sins in the world come in the name of religion. People are fired up about something and something they should be fired up. A person's always at danger then of doing an averus. Gufa, because you're, picture this person, they're such a giver, they're giving and doing, and they love Yidden, and they're Mekarev and Meirich, everybody. But Al tar besicha ma'isha, you're at threat in your great kindness organization, your great kirev you're doing, the great efforts for chaylim, the great efforts for sick people, you're liable then to break other halachas, there's a full Torah. Al tar besicha ma'isha, be careful not to talk to an isha too much. It's wonderful the idealism you're doing. It's tremendous, commendable. You're the mamish spitz person. You're a guy whose house is wide open. Aniyim are so welcome and loved and celebrated, but be careful, al tar besicha ma'isha. I'm always moved with all of Avram Avinu's kirev. Avram, the greatest mekarev, Avram Avinu, it says Avram mekarves ha'anashim, v'sara mekarves ha'anashim. He was careful. He wasn't mekarev the ladies. It was wonderful idealism what he's doing, but there was a great zehirus. There's nashim and anashim, and he was careful. This is something to always be careful all our lives. This mission is not an aberration. Whenever you're passionately serving Hashem and doing what's right, be careful not to run over anybody. Mark yourself, check yourself, ask yourself, It's very cool that you're fiery about an idealism and get that way. Nobody's saying not to get that way. Be on fire in your life with mission. Be consumed, a fire of a tafkid, of a mission, but always measure and be careful. So this Mishnah is a gorgeous Mishnah. The Mishnah which has a person who's a giver, what we're all supposed to be, a massive giver. And he physically gives and emotionally supports and values. Al tarbe sicha ma'isha. In your great organization, your building, don't speak too much to an isha. This Mishnah is like prophecy. It's like a prophetic Mishnah. How many times people make organizations and there become this danger? Uh-oh, in the organization, this Mishnah is brilliant and it doesn't take away from the great idealism you're doing. Do all the idealism, but just be careful. Think it through. Do it in a way that's true with the whole Torah, Shlemus. Doing one mitzvah doesn't pardon other mitzvahs. This Mishnah is so powerful. Altar v'sicha ma'isha. The Mishnah that's described such a generous, kind-hearted giver who's doing so much for so many in such a powerful way. And the Mishnah warns, you're a little vulnerable, Rav Yid. You're doing and you're on fire and your organization is wonderful. Your bias is pasuach. Aniyim amamish comfortable, altar v'sicha. Check it out, think it through, make sure it follows all the will of Hashem, that it's done in the way, the whole organization in the way of Hashem. That's altar v'sicha ma'isha. We've said before, somebody's a Rebbe, Rebbe Yerucham's example. Somebody's a Rebbe. It's tremendous. You're working with your guys. Great. Don't speak Lashon Hara about them. It's not matir. You're passionate. You're doing is not matir Lashon Hara. That's all b'chlal what this Mishnah was teaching. Be passionate. Be involved and do. Altar v'sicha ma'isha. Beautiful, beautiful Mishnah. If I can ask before we share, One more vert. We said that Chaim and Shloima would sing something tonight. We cut him off this morning. It was late. So Chaim and Shlomo.
Chaim's not there.
I want to tell you something.
Yeah.
On the chat is Kalman Nachlin, Ari's brother. So it's really, I want to thank Kalman for being here and being with us. It means a lot that you're here. Thank you, Kalman. Thank you, Usher, for being here. Kalman's the Tata. Ari's Ben Kalman. So it's Usher Nachlin. I thank Ari for being here. I wanna introduce, he doesn't need an introduction, but I wanna thank Shloima for always so sharing with his talents. Please, Shloima. Chaim's not here tonight.
He's not here.
We're hearing you solo, Shloima.
Yeah, I'm down. I'm always better with time, but. should we sing something now? I'm just.
Shloima.
Yeah. Does Rebbe have any good ideas?
I think we've gotten you so used to the duet part. Now going solo is like,
I'm like a little confused right now.
Going solo. Chaim has down the Zoom harmonies, how to do it, and it comes through. He has like some deal with the computer that they let his voice. Harmonies are hard in this. I don't know what he hooked up with the computer company.
It's cool. I've been trying to figure it out.
If you could sing Kirvas Eli Kimli Taiv,
yeah.
You're sitting next to Aaron Metz and Aryeh Banet. If this was live, I'd have all three of you sing together. But it doesn't work on computer. If you can do Kirvas Eli Kimli Taiv, Shloima.
I happen to be the Nachlin's cousin somehow, which is true. He just wrote on the thing.
Kalman's the father. Rev Kalman's the father, right? It's Usher now.
Father, so Rib Kalman, but yeah.
Take it away.
Vivani Kirvas Eli Kim. Kirvas Eli Kim. Litai Bani Kirvas Eloikim Kirvas Elohim Litai. Ina na na ina na 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 na.
Wow. I'm trying to figure out if Josh is on tonight. If the Nathans know, yo, do you know if Josh Goslin is on tonight? Would Yehuda roll no? Menachem Wiener, is Josh on? You're calling him. Wow. I'm going to share another vert quickly, and then we'll have another song. I want to say a vert I've never said publicly again. This is a special time. This whole time period is something unusual. So I want to share this for this time. I want to share a vert. I don't think, I may have told Rav Ezi this one, but I'm not positive. Listen to this vert, Yosef Mammon. Huda Krupka, can you? How are you, Huda?
I'm all right. It's good.
Let me ask you, without a guitar and just the vocals, it's possible to sing Uvne, or it doesn't work like that?
Definitely not by myself.
Wow. It's probably a needs guitar. When we get back guitars and the like, we need you to go off on that one. I need you and Benny singing Uvne. Mask him?
Yeah, for sure.
Wow, it's so nice. Also, you know what I'd love, Huda? I can picture you singing with Matt Levin. That would be like otherworldly. Huda, what song do you want to sing for us? I'm going to say a vart, and you pick a song you want to sing. Mask him?
Okay, sure.
After this vart, Huda, you'll be masking. No pressure. But when you hear this vart, you're probably going to want to sing. Listen to this vart, Huda, and you'll give me a thumbs up if you want, and a thumb sideways, meaning I'm going to go a different night. Okay, you'll tell me after this vart, but see if this vart gets you singing.
All right.
Like this, right? Yo, listen to this. Ezra Bork, listen to this vart. The next Mishnah, Perek Aleph Mishnah Vav. Yaakov, I wanted you to hear this vart. Manny, listen to this one. Hudi and Mo, listen to this vart. Yeshua ben Prachya v'nita arbeili kibu mehem. Yeshua ben Prachya oimer. A Mishnah everybody knows, Gav Leiter, listen to this part. We should get Yehuda Roll singing also. We need to get a little chat. I didn't say the verse. Let's get it clear. It's really how we know. But I want to know your thoughts. A little chat. Down.
How are we now, Yossi? Perfect. It's really very good. Excellent. So the Mishnah says, Mendi, the Mishnah says, Yaakov Ritschler, Mendi, Mendi, The Mishnah says three things. Asei lecha rav, make for yourself a Rebbe, Maish, Maishi Kalish, you have the seat right in the middle of the front screen, the way you belong. So Maish, it says like this, Asei lecha rav, make for yourself a Rebbe, Kinei lecha chaver, acquire a friend, Vavidanis kol adam l'kavzchos, judge everybody favorably. A Mishnah you've all learned many times in your life. Listen to this pshat that I think is emes lamite. Zevi Katz, you'll tell me if you mask him. Asei lecha rav speaks about you as the student. Make for yourself a Rebbe. So you're the student. And asei lecha rav, a person has to make themselves a Rebbe. It's a great act of humility like we described earlier. That's the first job, asei lecha rav, you as the student, as the one learning and absorbing. Asei lecha rav. Kinei lecha chaver is the friendship, is an equal. And the art of acquiring a friend, kinei lecha chaver. If we follow the flow, Havidan as kolam lekav zchus means you're on top, you're the parent already, you're the mashpia. In the first relationship, the Mishnah was talking about you're the mushpa, you're being impacted, asei lecha rav, through achna, through humility, asei, make for yourself a Rebbe. You have to do work, you have to create, you have, the work is humility. Kinei lecha chaver is that relationship that's back and forth. That's a chaver. And then the relationship of you being the mashpia is danes kol adam lekav zchus. And what I want to say, Rabbi, say, the secret in any relationship that you're trying to impact, you are now the Rebbe and you have talmidim. You're the parents and you have charges, you have children. The way that works is have a danes kol adam lekav zchus. See them good, don them favorably. The ikar yisoid in the relationship of the person as the mashpia. Ezra Shoma didn't go like this for this word. The ikar vart of you being mashpia is to see toiv, is don lekav zchus, is to see good people. Have a don, what am I, a judge? It says, dan people favorably. You're a psak? What's my psak? Yes. They're relationships that your psak creates the mitzius. And dan is kol adam lekav zchus. See people favorably. See them toiv. That is the essence of the relationship. When we are parents, when we are rebbeim, when we are mashpiyim, see, judge people favorably. See the tzidkus. That's how they done is called Mechav Schus Pashut Pshat, the three relationships. Asei Lecha Rav is when we want to get impacted, make a Rebbe be Machnia, to a friend, acquire a friend, is this relationship of the peer. And Dan is called Mechav Schus, when you are Taka the Paisik, when you are impacting, see people well. We only impact people in any way if we see them as tzaddikim in a real way. Rev Hirsch called it the bedrock of chinuch. The underlying yisayid of chinuch is danes kol adam lekav zchus, is to see good people, to good people you can impact and elevate and give greatness to. But danes kol adam lekav zchus. The lashon of the Mishnah is kol ha'adam. It doesn't say danes kol adam, it says kol ha'adam. And of course, part of Dan Lekav Schus is what we learned together. We were Zeiche. I like when two things come together. And we spoke this morning about Dan Lekav Schus. And one of the tricks of Dan Lekav Schus is knowing that there's a big part to the person. There's a lot we don't know. So it doesn't say as kol adam, every person. As kol ha'adam, the entirety of the person. Understand there's a lot to a person. A lot of circumstance, a lot of history. Be dan as kol ha'adam lekav schus. Understand that there are a lot of, there's a kol ha'adam. There's a lot of this man. So not just judging every person, but the entirety of a person, lekav zchus. Judge everybody favorably, see the entirety of the person. I do wanna ask Yehuda. Let's see if we could find Yehuda. Things moved around on the screen. Let's see if we, Yehuda. Yehuda, are we doing it tonight or a different night?
I don't think tonight. It was a great Vart. It got me fired up, but
100%. 100%, Huda. 100%. Thanks a million, Huda, for being here and always igniting us with your pictures, with your intelligence, with just who you are. Thank you, Huda, for being such an important member of our Chabura. Thank you, Huda. We want to hear from you. Please send Ezzy my love, Huda. Give him a hug from me.
I will.
This is a virtual hug for you, Huda. Thank you. Thank you, Huda. Thank you. Let's hear. Are the Steins still here? Josh is on?
Yeah.
Where's Josh? Let's see if we find Josh. Josh is here. Mm-hmm. What? We almost got you, Josh. Josh, how are you?
Good, Baruch Hashem. How's Rebbe?
Excellent. The whole Olam wants you. Once the chat like lights up asking for Josh, I don't want to... Is it true you're able to sing which song? You said he could do Uvene? You know Uvene, Josh?
The Waterbury one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
It
sounds better with a guitar.
It's true. It is true. It is true. Huda Krupp is one of the guys who composed Uvene.
I hear.
What song should we do, Josh? You've been two for two so far.
Anything specific?
Something you like.
Okay. Let's do it.
Let's do it. You're on, Josh.
Ein Hashem, Hashem Elokai, v'chol, v'chol, v'avi, v'chavda shimcha, shimcha li aylam, v'chavda shimcha li aylam. Aitch Hashem, Hashem Elokai, v'chol, v'chol, v'avi. V'chavda shimcha, li aylam. Hashem Elokai, ay bechal, ay bechal, levavi, levavi, vachavda.
Three for three, Josh. Excellent, excellent. Fantastic, Josh. I want to thank Josh. I want to thank Matt Levin. His chizuk and encouragement, what he has meant to our Chabura in this time is something otherworldly. So I want to thank Matt for always picking us up with such kindness and sweetness. We're a little choppy, girls.
Srili, how are we now? Excellent. Thank you, Matt Levin, for all the chizuk and encouragement and uplift that you've given us in this time. Thank you, Josh, for the beautiful singing. We'll close out, Rabbi Say, with the father and son that we all want to hear badly, Reb David Stein and Yitzhak Shalom Stein.
Shalom, my boy.
What do you hold, Yitzhak Shalom?
Sounds like a plan, Rabbi.
Let's do it for the Olam. Chizuk for them, the covered. Excellent.
Does Rabbi have,
you pick the song. It's like, Shalom, you picked, you've been 2 for 2. You pick the song.
Okay, fine. You said this to you.
Nafshi, nafshi, chamda. Chamda, metzel, yodecha. Oy, lo da. Oy, lo da. Oy, lo Nafshi, nafshi, chamda. Chamda, betzel, yadecha. Oy lo das korosay decha
That was unreal. Thank you, Yitzhak Shalom. Thank you, Reb David. Thank you. Beautiful. Thank you so much, Josh. Rabbi Say, I want to thank the Olam for coming and learning Torah together. Beis Hashem, tomorrow we'll learn at 2 o'clock till 2:40. The new time is 2 to 2:40. Many have Seder afterwards. And then we'll continue tomorrow night. Beis Hashem, at 8:30, we'll continue Avos. We're up to Mishnah Zayin, Perek Aleph Mishnah Zayin Avos, tomorrow night. We will, Beis Hashem, be having some guests on at night, a little bit here and there to share some Mishnahs. We're going to ask some of the Olam. Tomorrow night will be Perek Aleph Mishnah Zayin. Have an excellent night. Thank you so much, Rabbi Say. Good night, Yosef Sandler. Good night to the whole Chevra. Thank you.